We also have done these kinds of studies where we were looking at, this is work that's done at Horseshoe Bend Agroecosystem, University of Georgia. When we started out in 1980, we started out in this system. It was a 2-acre system that had been in conventional agriculture for approximately 30, 35 years. Been using all the standard pesticides, herbicides, fertilizers to grow the, you know, successional rotation crops, corn, soybean, sorghum, back to corn, you know, so there was a sequence for you. One of the acres was converted to sustainable. Back in 1980, how did the USDA define sustainable ag? Sustainable was synonymous with no-till. Okay, just because you stopped tilling something that had been in conventional practices for 30 years, are you putting the biology back into the system? Where are they coming from? They've been killed for 30 years. Where are those organisms going to come back from? There's nothing surrounding these 2 acres that would have any of the proper inoculum in them, surrounded by other farmland that's been treated with pesticides for the last 30 years. So just because we stopped tilling over here, does that mean we got the biology back into the soil? And the first year after going sustainable, it was a total disaster. It was horrible. We planted corn, made normal corn you'd till, but not here. Why? Because in the fall, in the autumn, we planted a green cover crop, a green manure is what it's called, an oat crop. And then when we tilled that, when we mowed that crop down the next spring, we had about 10 centimeters depth of green plant material sitting now on the surface of the soil. And it starts raining in Georgia. It rains all winter long. It rains all spring long. So what happened is that plant material sat there on the surface of the soil. It started getting all stinky, anaerobic. Went out there with tractors to try to plant the crop into the field, and all that happened with the tractor tires was they just spun. No traction, because you're trying to drive something over slime, anaerobic, putrefying slime. So of course our first crop wasn't very good. Think about when we did get it direct drilled and we planted those corn seeds, and they started to germinate and grow, and they are in anaerobic, putrefying material. Yeah, it just turned the corn seedlings into anaerobic, putrefying material. So, no, we didn't make a very good crop the first year. Just because you stop tilling doesn't mean you fix anything out in the soil. So, at the end of that first growing season, we put compost out. We put the proper biology back into that soil. We only put a bare dusting on the surface of that soil, but the plant material started decomposing right away. All this leftover slime sitting on the surface of the soil started decomposing, and we started rebuilding soil structure. So in 1981, it was a severe drought year. That year it was soybean that had gone back into the system, so both sides were soybean. We made almost no yield over here at all, and we made normal yields here because we were starting to build structure in the soil and we were holding water. This side, no structure at all. There was no way to hold water. Water over here, the water just flushes right through and ends up in groundwater. We held water and we made normal yields. By 1984, no pesticides were required. We had gotten rid of the pest problems. We used to have aphids, we had all kinds of scale insect, we had grasshoppers, we had just a slew of different kinds of insect pests. By 1986, we had redeveloped the OABC horizons in that soil. Good structure, down to a couple of meters within the soil. So from that time, you know, 4 pounds of fertilizers per acre, 4 kilograms per hectare of fertilizer to grow a crop of corn. You can't do that in a conventional system. In this conventional system, it takes 400 kilograms of fertilizer per hectare to grow a crop. And we're growing a better crop on 4 kilograms. Over the years, even that's disappeared. because of the green cover cropping, because of the nitrogen fixation that now goes on in that soil, we don't use any fertilizer at all. And we grow better yields. These papers are published in these different kinds of journals. You want to go talk to somebody who's continuing this work, Dave Coleman, Paul Hendricks at the University of Georgia. Go talk with them.